Hey gamers, it's Ed Park, aka Taugrim. I want to talk to you about whether it's possible to stunlock in Guild Wars 2. The short answer is yes, it is possible, but it takes two to tango. It requires for player A to spec into multiple CC abilities that can be chained together, and for player B to opt not to take traits or abilities that provide the stability buff, or to spec into crowd control breakers. So I'm going to illustrate these points by showing you footage of my Captain Hammer Warrior fighting against other warriors who are spec'd very differently. So here's an Asura Greatsword Warrior. I knock him back with my Hammer 4, interrupt the ability he was casting, and then he starts to run and pops his heal. And I'm going to intercept him with my Hammer Burst ability right there, which is a gap closer and a stun. He counters with his Bull Charge knockdown. I have multiple CCs to work with, so I go ahead and use my Mace 5 to knock him down, and then my Mace Burst ability to stun, and then I finish him off. And you can tell this player doesn't have the stability buff, and he doesn't have any crowd control breakers, so he's very susceptible to being CC'd. And, you know, in this game, the extent to which you end up being crowd controlled is, in my opinion, a matter of choice. It depends on how much CC counter or immunity you spec into your character. And so, with all things in Guild Wars 2, it's really a trade-off decision. You have to decide the capabilities that you want in a given spec. Compared to most games, the CC abilities in this game have a very short duration, typically only 1 to 2 seconds, but there is no diminishing returns or any concept like that in this game. So here's another example. The Asura Greatsword Warrior comes back, bulls charge me, bulls rush, knocks me down, and then I hit him with a Hammer 5 knockdown, and I go ahead and working through my stun cycle. He's already down. He's also spec'd pretty squishy. And in this game, it's really important to consider, in my opinion, three things from a defensive standpoint. How you manage incoming direct damage, how you deal with sustained condition application on you, and how you deal with crowd control effects. So this Asura Warrior knocks me back with his Rifle 5 knockback, stuns me with his Hammer Burst ability. Now it's my turn. I go ahead and knock him down with my Hammer 5, use my Hammer 4 to knock him back, use my Hammer Burst ability to stun him, so that's about 6 seconds of disabling CC, and then I pop my Fear Bomb, switch over to Maces, knock him down with the Mace 5 ability right there, and I still have my Mace Burst ability if needed. Now, you might look at this and say, wow, this looks kind of overpowered. You know, keep in mind that in my particular case, I am specing for weapons that have a relatively low damage capability, but have high CC capability. And again, it's all about choice in this game. I'm getting hammered here. I pop off my shouts to give myself some healing and then drop my Fear Bomb. And as I'm kiting away, I go ahead and use my heal. So, you know, Guild Wars 2 specking, it's all about trade-offs. Actually, when I first looked at the CC durations in this game, it seemed so odd because they were so short. Like, you know, how effective really is a 1 second or 2 second stun going to be? And it depends upon how you're spec'd. You know, like I said, if you have multiple crowd control abilities, multiple stuns, and you can chain them together, prevent your opponent from healing, etc. So right there you can see I knocked down my opponent from range with a Mace 5 knockdown, and I'm just getting absolutely hammered here. I go ahead and pop a shout, which gives me a heal with this particular spec. You can find out about the spec in the description for this video, and you can see I use my Hammer 5 knockdown there on my opponent because I know he doesn't spec for any CC counters. Once I knock him down, he can't touch me. Go ahead and strafe out of line of sight, bridge to my next heal, and then get my health back up into a manageable state again. So let me know what you think about this video in the comments below. If you enjoyed it, please like, share, favorite, and subscribe. And let me know what other questions you have about Guild Wars 2. I'm working on some other videos, which I'm going to publish after this one. And as always, I appreciate your feedback. Take care.